explanation is just to tell you that, yes, I did mice experiments for my doctorate thesis and I handled mice myself, but obviously it was only for a brief period of time and it was also 4 years ago. And so a lot of things in the lab I have to relearn, also because here we don't work with mice. In my new group, we work with PBMCs, so they are basically blood samples we gathered from patients. Yeah, so all in all, at the beginning, there is a lot of new stuff for me to learn, not only theoretically, I have to read a lot of new textbooks and papers, but also lab work I have to learn from my colleagues. But the problem is, my colleagues, they are all already in the final phase of their PhD, so they're quite busy. By wife, and I told that to the girl sits next to me because she is not in my group, but almost like she's in my group. That's a completely other story. But essentially what happened is that because our PI is a doctor and a quite young doctor, so he's for the most part in the clinic and not in the lab. So my PI, who's a researcher, kind of adopted her to our group. But anyways, she also said that once she showed the data to our chief, she is obviously dealing with her data every day, but our chief just read through it, like glimpsed over her data and find some correlations that she didn't even realize. And I don't know, I just have this feeling. I don't know if I would meet the expectation of my chief, and that's just in several points. Like, for example, he also said to me that I should attend infectious disease symposium, which I attended, but he actually said to me that I should do some networking. It's good for me to know some people in this field, but I feel like it is so hard to make the first step to meet new people in this kind of situation if you are not with your group and if nobody introduces you to other people, because usually I have no problem talking to people at all, but it's just in this specific situation, you know, on conference and at a conference or symposium, I have no idea like who should I talk to, because for example this time the symposium is about infectious disease in general, where as my group's focus, especially my PI's focus, and therefore also my focus is more on tumor. So we do, because my chief, like, so the big boss is also doing a lot of research on hepatitis, but for my project alone, I'm not dealing with hepatitis that intensively. But even so, in the whole symposium, there are a lot of people giving talks about other fields of infectious research, like respiratory viruses, bacteriology, and using big data to predict emergence, is that the word, coming of new viruses and stuff like that. So I'm like, honestly, a lot of things just go from this year in and this year out, so I feel very well overwhelmed. And I also talked to my mom after that day and told her that basically I feel like I'm lacking and I feel like I'm not smart enough, and that it's either, you know, too few challenges or too much challenges in the work. It's hard to find something that you feel like you're challenged, but you can handle it well. A lot of the times in our field, it's the same in the clinics too. Like as a junior doctor, you also have so much to study and so many new skills and thought process of you know, seeing patients. You have to, you know, see them for the first time, not just reading them from textbooks. And I know everything comes with time and experience, but still, for me at least, a lot of the times since I finished medical school, I feel you know, certain level of anxiety, and secret. It's really cool to be in this environment, and apparently everybody is treating me well, and we have a clear goal, and people are also giving you like advices and clear plan for the next step. So just try to enjoy the time there, give your best, and not everybody is maybe as intelligent and hardworking and driven like my chief, but you know, she said that we need these people in our society in every field, but you yourself can give your best. If this doesn't work out, never mind, you can just, you know, do clinical work, and it's still going to be a fulfilling life. And she's basically very understanding. She also said she and my dad are already very proud of me for basically completing also my doctorate thesis, which I'm still going to defend this year, but I submit the paper, and you know, the so basically you have to publish a paper. You don't have to publish a paper, but if you publish a paper, then it's like you can get also the best grade for that. So that I've done, and she said that they are already very, very proud of me, and they said that so my parents basically never gave me the pressure to stay in academia, and yeah, they basically let me do whatever I want to do with my life, which is really sweet of them. On another note, I find this so funny because, you know, in some aspects my mom is like such a sweetheart, but on other aspects, like, I'm like, I don't know why you're saying this. So basically what happened is, I think a few days back we were also doing video chat, and she just looked at me, and I didn't have any makeup on that day, so you can see the hyperpigmentation on my face clearly. And she basically gave me this talk that how I just let myself go and don't care about my appearance, and this is not good. I should take more care of how I look. And I'm like, Mom, I'm using sunscreen every day. What else? What more can I do for my skin? And I remembered it was the same thing. My mom is not happy with my height because I'm 160, right? And she has hoped for me to be a little bit taller, which I'm like, Mom, you're shorter than me. My dad is not tall. This is in the genetics. But my mom basically said to me, it's because I didn't do enough sports when I was a child, because look at all the other kids, like my cousin and like kid of a colleague of my parents. The parents are also not much taller than my parents, but the boys, two of them, are very tall. And I got this talk all the time growing up. But so this time when my mom gave me this talk that how I ignored my appearance, I just, you know, I'm not mad, I'm not depressed. Oh, one other thing that she said is that she thinks that for the most part I am pretty, but I got the nose of my dad, which is not